Hello students, today we'll start our next exercise, that is exercise 1.5. So our first question is, classify the following numbers as rational or irrational. That means we have to classify the following numbers, that these numbers are rational or irrational numbers. So our first part is 2 minus under root 5. We all know that 2 is a rational number and under root 5 is an irrational number. So if we'll subtract an irrational number from a rational number, then our answer would be an irrational number. Therefore, 2 minus under root 5 is an irrational number. Now, second part is 3 plus under root 23 minus under root 23. So if we'll open this bracket, then what will come? 3 plus under root 23 minus under root 23. So plus 23 and minus 23 will cancel out. And what is left? 3 is left, which is a rational number. Therefore, 3 plus under root 23 minus under root 23 is a rational number. Now, our third part is 2 under root 7 upon 7 under root 7. Here, if you notice that under root 7 is in the denominator and numerator both. So, both will cancel. Then, what is left? 2 upon 7 is left, which is a rational number. Therefore, 2 under root 7 upon 7 under root 7 is a rational number. Now, fourth part is 1 upon under root 2. 1 is a rational number and under root 2 is an irrational number. If we divide a rational number by an irrational number, we will get an irrational number. Therefore, 1 upon under root 2 is an irrational number. Now, our fifth part is 2 pi. 2 is a rational number and pi is an irrational number. If we'll do the decimal expansion of pi, then what will come? That will come 3.1415, which is non-terminating and non-repeating. We all know non-terminating and non-repeating numbers are irrational numbers. And if we'll multiply a rational number with an irrational number, our result is an irrational number. Therefore, 2 pi is an irrational number. Now, we'll proceed towards question number 2. Simplify each of the following expressions. Our first part is 3 plus under root 3, 2 plus under root 2. Here we have to multiply a binomial with the other binomial. So, firstly we'll multiply 2 plus root 2 by 3, then 2 plus root 2 by under root 3. So, if we'll multiply 3 with 2, then 3 to the 6, then 3 multiply root 2 is 3 root 2. Then under root 3 multiply 2 is 2 root 3. And under root 3 multiply under root 2 is under root 6. So this is the solution of this part. Now if we move towards our second part, that is 3 plus under root 3, 3 minus under root 3. So here looking this, you know, one identity is there similar to this. What is that? That is a plus b, a minus b is equals to a square minus b square. So here we will use that identity. So 3 square is equals to 9 and under root 3 square is equals to 3. So 9 minus 3 is equals to 6. So this is all about this. Now next part is under root 5 plus under root 2 ka whole square. So one more identity is there like this. That is a plus b ka whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So if we'll do the square of under root 5, then 5 will come. If we'll do the square of under root 2, then 2 will come. And if we multiply 2 by under root 5 and under root 2, then 2 under root 10 will come. 5 plus 2 becomes 7 and 2 under root 10 will write as it is. So our solution is 7 plus 2 under root 10. So, fourth part is under root 5 minus under root 2, under root 5 plus under root 2. So, when we will multiply this Again, we will use the identity a minus b, a plus b is equal to a square minus b square. So, square of under root 5 is 5 and square of under root 2 is 2. So, 5 minus 2 is equals to 3. Question number 3 now. Recall, pi is defined as the ratio of the circumference of a circle to its diameter. That is, pi is equals to c by d. This seems to contradict the fact that pi is irrational. Therefore, how will you resolve this contradiction? Answer is, we know that when we measure the length of a line or a figure by using a scale or any device, we do not get an exact measurement. In fact, we get an approximate rational value. So, we are not able to realize that either circumference or diameter of a circle is irrational. Therefore, we can conclude that as such there is not any contradiction regarding the value of pi, and we realize that the value of pi is irrational. Now, we move towards question number 4. In this, we have to represent under root 9.3 on the number line. So, how we will represent that? Firstly, we'll draw a line segment AB of 9.3 unit. Then we will extend that 1 unit, that is BC is equals to 1 unit. Then we will find the midpoint of AC and name that midpoint as O. Now taking the distance AO in our compasses, from O we'll draw a semicircle. Then from B we'll draw a perpendicular that meet the semicircle at point D. Now BD will represent under root 9.3. And taking the distance BD in our compasses, from B we'll draw an arc meeting the number line at point E. And BE will represent under root 9.3. So in this way we can represent any number on the number line. Suppose we have to represent under root X on the number line. So how we will do that? So similarly, we will do, firstly, we'll make a line segment AB of length X unit. Then we'll extend that 1 unit, BC is equals to 1 unit. Then we'll find the midpoint of AC and name the midpoint as O. Then taking the distance AO in our compasses, from O, we'll draw a semicircle. Then from B, we'll draw a perpendicular meeting the semicircle at point D. Then BD will represent under root X. Now taking the distance BD in our compasses, from B we'll draw an arc on the number line and we'll name that point as E. Now BE will represent under root X. So in this way we can represent any number on the number line. Now question 5th is, rationalize the denominators of the following. Our first part is 1 upon under root 7. So here we have to rationalize our denominator, means we have to remove under root from here. So how under root will be removed? If we multiply the numerator and denominator by under root 7, then in the numerator 1 multiply under root 7 is under root 7, and in the denominator under root 7 multiply by itself, then it becomes 7. So our answer is under root 7 upon 7. Now second part is 1 upon under root 7 minus under root 6. So looking at the denominator, it is clear it is like a minus b. And if we multiply this by a plus b, then our identity a square minus b square we can use. So here we'll multiply this by under root 7 plus under root 6, both the numerator and denominator. So in the numerator what will come? Under root 7 plus under root 6 will come, and in the denominator square of under root 7 is 7 and square of under root 6 is 6. So on solving this, what we will get? Under root 7 plus under root 6 upon 1, which is equals to under root 7 plus under root 6, right? So our next part is 1 upon under root 5 plus under root 2. So here if you notice, in our denominator we are having a plus b, So if we'll multiply it by a minus b, then a square minus b square will come. So here in the numerator and denominator, we'll multiply it by under root 5 minus under root 2. So when we'll multiply that, what will come? In the numerator, under root 5 minus under root 2 will come, and in the denominator, square of under root 5 minus square of under root 2 will come. And when we will solve this, in the numerator, under root 5 minus under root 2 will come, and in the denominator, 5 minus 2 will come. Then on solving this, what we will get? We'll get under root 5 minus under root 2 upon 3. Right, so this is the solution of this part. Now let's move towards next part, that is 1 upon under root 7 minus 2. So here, looking at the denominator, it is clear it is a minus b, and if we multiply it by a plus b, then a square minus b square will come. So here in the denominator and numerator, we'll multiply it by under root 7 plus 2. On multiplying, in the numerator we'll get under root 7 plus 2, and in the denominator we will get under root 7 ka square minus 2 ka square. And on solving that, in the numerator we'll get under root 7 plus 2, and in the denominator under root 7 ka square is 7 and 2 ka square is 4. So our result will be under root 7 plus 2 upon 3. So this is all about this exercise. Thank you.